Okay, so apparently I have no more internet right now, so I'm gonna do this review anyways, even though I have no internet right now, and I can't look up the names of the people because I am terrible at remembering names, so I am warning you beforehand. I will not remember any of the names of the people in this drama, so I'm sorry in advance. Hello and welcome back to the viewing list. Today I have a video for you guys because I haven't done one in ages, and so I decided to do a video today. Today I'm gonna be reviewing the K-drama Chicago Typewriter or Chicago Tajagi. This is a drama about a guy who I can't remember the name of, but I'll leave it on the screen. He is a writer. He's like a famous writer, and he's suffering with a huge case of writer's block. Okay, so he discovers that he has a ghostwriter who is in fact a ghost. And he's the ghost of a guy that our main character knew in his previous life. However, in this life, our main character cannot remember much of anything, but meeting this guy kind of jogs his memory and he starts remembering more. And the ghost, who I'll put the name of right here because I can't remember his name, he is on a mission to find out who killed him and why, and he's also trying to finish a promise that he made to his friend. But he could not keep in his previous life, so he's trying to fulfill that promise. And then there's also our writer's number one fan, who is kind of at the center of these two guys, and it's very strange. This drama, if I would say in a few words, is very emotional. Like, it's nostalgic and it's sad at times and happy at times and confusing and mysterious and just ridiculously good. I had no problems with any of the characters except the girl character. Sometimes I was a bit annoyed because she was a little kind of innocent. And there was this other character that I didn't like because she's a bit over dramatic, so like, stop overreacting, it's annoying. That kind of feeling I was having, but then most of the time I didn't really mind her, but then there was this one scene that I just couldn't get over how ridiculous it was. My favorite character, actually, is the ghost because he's lovable and adorable and funny, and like, I love his character so much. Like, just so much, way more than the main lead and the main girl lead. Like, I love the ghost more than the two of them. So overall, I had no problems with the characters and I really enjoyed the story. It's probably one of those things I'm not gonna enter into lightly anymore because like, I know what's gonna happen and it's just gonna hit me so hard when I watch it over. Like, all the feels from this drama are like so, like, the feels. This drama should be described as the feels, because you feel all the feels when you watch this drama. So, in conclusion, I gave this drama was it 9.5? I think I gave this drama a 9.5 out of 10 on my drama list. I'm not actually sure if that's right. If it's not right, I'm gonna just put in the rating I gave it. So if you have not watched it yet, I really suggest you do because it's very entertaining. Like, I don't know if to say it's happy. It's not happy, and it's not totally sad, but I enjoyed it. So it's entertaining enough to keep my attention. So if you have seen this drama, please let me know down below what you thought about it. And who was your favorite character? Let's have a convo down in the comments. If you have any drama recommendations for me, also leave them down below because I would really like to check them out, even though I have a really long list of dramas on my drama list to check out. But, you know, I like suggestions anyway, so just like tell me what kind of dramas you think I would like. If there's anything in particular you want me to review, also let me know and I will check it out and we shall see how that goes. I can't promise that I'll do a review of it, but I'll check it out and then we'll see if I want to review it or not. Please leave me a like if you like this video and subscribe if you want to see more of my videos. And I will see you next time in another video. Until then, goodbye.